Hello, aviation professionals, my fellow airline pilots, aircraft maintenance personnel, and aviation safety professional. Welcome again to my aviation training solution for today. Your host is always Haysam Ali, and I am an aviation technical instructor. Today, it will be a live training session, and it is for safety, primarily for safety. It is for the safety of my fellow airline pilots and aircraft maintenance personnel. What about today's topic? I will talk about the aircraft tire pressure indications. Imagine you are an aircraft maintenance personnel and you need to sign an aircraft for flight. So you make your walk around and check the aircraft wheels, and you can find the aircraft wheel and tires in a good condition, and there is no indication that the pressure inside these wheels are in out of range. So you will go to the cockpit and bring the aircraft displays and bring the tire pressure indication page. And while you are checking the tire pressure for each wheel, you can find this is the indications. For example, this aircraft having a normal tire pressure of 210 psi. And the instruments are giving you a normal tire pressure range. 205 and 210 and 200. There is no problem regarding this scenario. On the other side, if you make your walk around and go into the cockpit to check the tire pressure on the instruments, and you can find one wheel, for example, wheel number two, its tire pressure indication about 170 psi. And again, the normal tire pressure is about 210. So now we are having a very big difference between the normal range and the tire pressure range. So you open the aircraft maintenance manual and you can find that you can increase this tire pressure to the normal tire pressure. So you will take an action to bring a nitrogen cart to start increase this tire pressure indication from 170 to 210. Also, it will be okay, but you need to take an important step before commencing to blow air in this tire. You need to go and bring a tire pressure gauge and manually go to the wheel and check the tire pressure of this wheel with a tire pressure gauge before starting to blow nitrogen inside this wheel. So why you need to make this? To be sure that this electrical tire pressure indication are good, because it is a big difference. So if you start automatically to blow nitrogen inside this wheel before checking it manually with a tire pressure gauge, and if it's a false indication, the aircraft tire or this tire will explode and it will make a disaster to the mechanic or the technician who are performing this action. So it is a very simple safety feature and a very important safety feature. You need to take an action regarding it to ensure that this tire pressure indication are good, and it is very important to start this manual test before commencing to increase the tire pressure of this wheel, as it is a big difference. So if it is a false indication, probably this tire may explode and it will be very dangerous regarding the mechanic or technician who will perform this tire pressure blowing action. Thank you for your good listening, and always maintain your aircraft safely and fly safely. And for more training session like this, stay tuned on the upcoming days, as I will reveal aircraft system facts, and also I will put a live video regarding brake temperature and the wheel tire at the end of this video right now. So I'm ready for any feedback, and also fly safely, or again, fly safely and maintain your aircraft very safely. From Cairo, Egypt, your host is Haysam Ali. Thank you for your good listening, and goodbye.